What were the odds this Illinois child would become one of the world's great mathematicians? David Blackwell was game to try.
I was always pretty good at mathematics. I don't know that I had favorite subjects. I studied whatever you were told to study. Did it as well as I could, but I looked forward to recess. I was a good student, mind you.
Such a good student that by age 22, he had earned a PhD from the University of Illinois.
There's a lot of luck in things. The man that I chose as my thesis advisor was far and away the best possible choice I could have made. His field, probability theory, turned out to have a lot of appeal for me. It turned out that I liked to think that way.
Blackwell wanted to teach mathematics, and he wanted to serve at historically black colleges and universities.
I got a list of all the black colleges from some almanac, and there were 105 of them. I wrote 105 letters.
I actually accepted the first offer that I received as soon as I got it.
And my really serious mathematical work started at Howard. At Howard, the intellectual atmosphere was just different.
Suppose that every day a machine produces a number, either 0 or 1.
In the mid-50s, Blackwell joined and soon after headed the University of California, Berkeley's newly created statistics department. Over the years, Blackwell continued to expand mathematics by introducing game theory, decision theory, and information theory into the field.
Let's suppose in particular that we knew that all these xn's were greater than or equal to 1/2.
David Blackwell, the first African-American elected to the National Academy of Sciences, dedicated to assisting disadvantaged students in the U.S. and Africa.
First, the advice I would give to young people generally is try everything and keep looking until you find something that you like.